This section should give a short introduction to cuts, crush injury, foreign bodies in the eye, and dental injury. The extent of the injury depends on the cause. Cuts can be clean or dirty. Clean cuts are the result of very sharp objects that easily cut through skin, tissue, muscles and tendons. Dirty cuts are often torn and contaminated by dirt, oil or chemicals. All crew members should have had recent tetanus shots, as this is not an ideal condition to treat while at sea. Any major bleeding must be stopped before treating the wound. The following elements must be considered during the examination. What is the structure of the wound? The following two questions must be clarified before anaesthetic can be given. Is there movement distal to the injury? Is there feeling distal to the injury? Is it a clean injury? In order to treat cuts, stop the bleeding and elevate the bleeding part. Clean the wound with sterile saline solution, 9 mg per milliliter, or hydrogen peroxide. If hydrogen peroxide is used, rinse with salt water solution. Close the wound, either with tape, sterile strips, or by stitches. Bandage the wound. If there are signs of tendon damage, the tendon must be sutured by a surgeon before closing the wound. If so, put on a dressing until qualified treatment can be administered. If blood penetrates the bandage, this must be changed frequently. If the bandage is clean and dry, it can be left unchanged until the stitches are removed. Daily observation is necessary. The consequences of a crush injury depend on the size of the damage and how much force the wound has been exposed to. The effect on the tissue after a crush injury is that a large number of cell membranes will rupture and cell contents will leak into the tissue. This will cause oedema, swelling, within the tissue. A number of small and large blood vessels will puncture and cause effusion of blood. Crushed tissue will cause some of the tissue cells to die. In order to examine a crush injury, your aims are to find out how extensive the injury is, if the skin is punctured, and if the casualty is in pain. When treating a crush injury, you should elevate damaged part and put a compress to the wound. Disinfect the damaged area. It may be necessary to remove or cut away dead tissue. Local anaesthetic may be necessary. It is not recommended to suture an open wound immediately. This can easily cause infection, as dead tissue may still be present in the wound. Adequate treatment is to cover the injured area with a compress with salt water solution, close to the wound with a dry compress on top. Change the bandage at least once daily. If necessary, remove dead tissue. When the wound after some days appears sterile, it may be sutured. A speck of dust, loose eyelash or even a contact lens can literally float on the white of the eye and is usually easily removed. However, anything that sticks to the eye, penetrates the eyeball or rests on the coloured part of the eye should not be touched. There may be blurred vision, pain or discomfort, redness and watering of the eye, eyelids screwed up in spasm, in order to treat foreign bodies in the eye, your aim is to prevent injury to the eye. Your aims are to find out how extensive the injury are, if the skin is punctured, and if the casualty is in pain. Gently separate the eyelids with your finger and thumb. Examine every part of his eye. Ask him to look right, left, up and down. If the foreign body is sticking to or embedded in the eye, cover the affected eye with an eye pad and a bandage. Then take or send the casualty to a hospital. If you can see a foreign body on the white of the eye, wash it out with a glass or an eye bath and clean water. Pour water on inner corner of eye. Let the water drain onto a towel. If this is unsuccessful, providing the foreign body is not stuck in place, lift it off with a moist swab or the damp corner of a tissue or clean handkerchief. If the object is under the upper eyelid, ask the patient to grasp the eyelashes and pull the lid over the lower lid. Blinking underwater may also make the object float clear. When the patient has a dental injury, the area surrounding the tooth will be red and an abscess may appear next to the tooth or towards the chin. This is often a painful situation for the patient. A dental injury may be treated as follows. Antibiotics. Pain reliever. An abscess may have to be punctured and treated with antibiotics. A root filling is not to be done on board.